great. Thank you guys for coming. Have fun and take your time. Oh, that's a good question. So we found a lot of this. I just walked out to the tide mark. So you'll see the woody debris. It's significantly. So you just saved like 20 animals potentially. So yeah, just remember that when you're out there. Yeah, yeah. And there's more bags here for you guys.
Oh, fun. Oh, those are those little pickers. You want to use it?
Yeah.
You can. Just go grab it. Yeah, you're good. Just bring it back. It goes to another nonprofit, but we'll get it back to them.
Yeah, I will.
Cool.
He was hoping to get a shovel. And take your time. I always tell people just enjoy yourself while you're out there. Remember why you're here, to take care of our earth, take care of the ocean, and enjoy it. Have a good time.
Yeah, thank you.
It's
a beautiful day to do it.
It's gorgeous.
Perfect day.
Yes. You want to get in the photo? Hold on, I'm going to take a photo. Help me take it. Help me take the photo. Ready? Say Earth Breeze. Thank you, guys. You can keep that if you want. Yeah? Awesome. Come back. You guys can get this bag.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Have fun. Did you get a cleanup bag, too? Did you want one? Oh, awesome. Yes. What'd you find?
So we found lots and lots of plastic bits and soda bottle bits.
Really? Seashells too?
Yep.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah. We found nice things too. That's true.
Awesome.
Let's go.
Have fun, guys. Is bioaccumulation and trophic transfer. And essentially what that means is the animals are eating the plastic and then it's getting eaten by a larger animal who gets eaten by a larger animal. And then eventually we fish it out of the ocean and we're eating it and it becomes part of our bodies. And that's not healthy because our bodies haven't evolved to digest it. So, yeah.
Beautiful. And a lot of people think that this may not be very much, but it's actually a lot. Like right now I can see this came from a firework, like a bottle rocket that shoots up. Which is kind of makes things interesting because a lot of it's unidentifiable. But after doing it so long, you see the whole piece, you see the shattered piece, and you just know what it's made out of. And most of all the plastic that's floating coming here is rigid plastic. And there's 7 plastics in the world that we're dealing with right now. And this piece, you can see the degradation. It's already chipping, falling apart, and getting more brittle. And so those little bitty pieces, you can still see them, but that's coming from the plastic of that.
You know, even just a few pieces can harm an animal
and be fatal.
You saw
like where
they were
cutting open the birds and, or like that they decompose and then you just see all the plastic like sitting in them.
Yeah.
It's just really sad.
Yeah.
I know there's like a lot of seabirds in Oregon too. So.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of animals are really affected by it, especially seabirds, turtles. Even whales, but there's so many gaps in the research that we just don't really know how bad it's really affecting them. But this is awesome. You guys are saving animals.
Look how much
nice
we got.
Work. High five. Yes. Thanks for coming out here and doing this, guys. What a wonderful day to spend your Earth
like
Day
not
weekend.
Even, it's not even windy.
I know. This is gorgeous.
So back in 2012, we were in Newport, Oregon on a beach and we brought some college students out for a beach cleanup. It was World Ocean Day. And you know, it was pretty neat because what they removed was so much plastic, I had no idea it was even on the beach. After that cleanup, these ideas came in. Wow, if I did a cleanup just every weekend, I would be removing thousands of pounds a year. So we did another cleanup and another cleanup. Well, it kept getting bigger and bigger. Well, the neat thing was, is like, okay, we're going to become a nonprofit now, because if we become a nonprofit, we can really make this large and make huge impact. Well, then we got our first sponsor, which was pretty neat. And it's like this sponsor, I remember him asking me, well, where does our donation go? And I think I was saying, well, it just goes right back in the ocean, which was kind of funny because it was like, we just throw your donation in the ocean. But, you know, honestly, what's so neat about Ocean Blue and being a part of this is we're able to take 100% of all donations from the communities and other places and just put it into removing plastic.
Yeah, exactly.
So those ships would just like leave, so they would like not even know that any of their plastic dumps.
They do know. Oh. It's accidental.
Oh.
But it happens. These nurdles, they end up all over. Where'd the nurdle go? They're so tiny.
So tiny.
But
I've probably got plenty
here's one. Here's a nurdle. And then oh, where'd it go? They're like magic.
I don't know what this might have been from.
It's hard to tell.
Very hard to tell.
Very hard to tell.
I know this was part of a bottle cap.
Yeah, probably a lot of those.
Yeah. I've only found one of them, actually. I'm in a large competition against everyone. No, I think that the grabbers work really well with wanting to get rid of all this like big stuff so you can get down on your hands because all this stuff is blocking it. So if you use the grabber you can get it. So you can get the majority of it that's here. Ooh, I've always wanted to use that word. Here. I learned that some of these white pellets were bunched into little balls and then they were sent across on a boat to the manufacturers, and an accident would happen on one of the boats, and these would be released into the water, and that's how they get here, from what I've heard.
Interesting.
Yeah. Also, I should never have chosen black. It's good in one way, bad in another. It keeps you nice and warm.
And sometimes too warm.
Yes. Sometimes very too warm. Even I run a lot, but here's some of the white pellets that I was talking about. They're really small.
That's how they start. They just get lost at sea and washed up. And
oh boy. Yeah, I keep finding lots of these.
Yeah. That's a nurdle.
That's interesting. I didn't know that before.
And when you see them, it's like, what is that? You know? What is that? That's a nurdle.
We're looking for nurdles, if you know what those are.
Yeah, I got a couple in here.
You got a couple in there?
Oh, yeah. I heard that they come from container ships. When they have an accident on the container ship, they get into the ocean. And then they come in onto the beaches. Let's see if we can find a couple.
And it's how plastic all starts.
Oh, no, not there. Nope.
No, not yet. Okay.
It might not be around here.
I was finding plastic. A bunch of them.
That's plastic. It's more waxy.
Yeah.
So there's some up there.
Yeah, you can usually
tell. I'll go find some.
Over time. The shells are more rough and rigid, but the plastic is more soft and waxy feeling.
That's what I thought. So
I had
like
a hard time for a long time. Like, is this a shell or is this plastic?
And I end up picking up a bunch of shell.
Yeah.
You're
trying to steal
but the shell is more rough.
Yeah, okay. Exactly.
I own them.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I found a nurdle.
And you got one.
Okay, you found a nurdle.
Yeah, so what is this?
What's a nurdle? This little round one?
We want to learn about nurdles.
Those are nurdles, and nurdles are what manufacturers use to set. So it starts out virgin plastic, and then it becomes a nurdle.
And then
those
get shipped across the sea, and then they
to become other products, melted
into
molds.
Like bigger products
but they might get lost at sea.
These, and then like when the ships have an accident, it all goes into water and it comes here. Where we find it. And then if they do manage to get through, then pieces that are finished come out.
You got it.
Mm-hmm. I got more in here. I have pieces.
You're an expert now.
Show us pull out one of the nurdles in your hand and just so I can shoot a close-up of it.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I got a lot in here.
Or use this one here that Chris has got.
There you go.
Put that in, there you go. Let me just see a little of those. Just hold them out there for us.
Plastic molds. Here's another one. These have been washing up for years.
And also, you guys are helping me fill up mine.
I know
mine.
How long they've been out there, you know? And what's cool is you guys are getting them before they get washed back out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because if they get washed back out, then we're all going to finish up, think that we got them all, and then when we leave, and then when the tide comes in tomorrow, there'll be more nurdles.
Right, in the hot sun, like on a day today, the sun is going to make it more brittle, and it's going to break apart a lot more easily and become so tiny that we can't even see it anymore.
Yeah, I think that's what happened to some of this stuff in here. Because this feels melted. This is melted a bit.
Oh, this one, see, this one just crushed in my hand a little bit and came apart really easily.
Yeah, I got a whole bunch of stuff in here. This is part of a comb.
Yeah, and plastic, that's how plastic got started, was combs, because they needed to find a replacement for ivory.
I remember when we were in Bend, Oregon, and we were just about to go on this, we called it a beach cleanup tour. We're gonna travel from Washington to California. We're gonna hit beaches on the entire way, remove as much as we could. And Box Water tapped us on the shoulder. You remember that?
I do. Thank you, Box Water. That was incredible. We got to go to LA and clean up Santa Monica beaches. They did a really cool contest with all of our supporters and their supporters, and figure out where do these people want to have a cleanup. And they ended up going and doing a cleanup with the zoo in Florida. So that was really fun. They got to vote, they chose, they cleaned up in Florida. And I've been around for 8 years, since 2014. And I've seen Ocean Blue grow from, you know, just this small cleanup happening in Nye Beach and urban stream restoration happening in Corvallis, in the urban stream there, to what it is today. And we're all over. We're in Florida, we're in LA, we're in all up and down the West Coast. Now we're in Hawaii cleaning up Camilo Beach. So it's really amazing to see it grow through the supporters. But you asked me what my favorite sponsor is. It has to be our individual donors.
Yes.
The people sitting at home and deciding, hey, I really wanna clean up the ocean. I wanna support. And so when somebody gives $50, we take those donations and we make sure that recovers, that goes to the recovery of 50 pounds of plastic and debris. Earth Breeze
was a cool
Earth Breeze
sponsor.
Is awesome, because what they're doing already, that's built into their brand, is they have a plastic-free laundry detergent option. So they have packaging to where it's not plastic. You're not like, what do I do with this plastic jug now that I'm done with my laundry soap? So Earth Breeze is awesome. They're supporting a lot of organizations. They're doing a lot of good things. So.
And we never mentioned like how much someone donated, because it's really not about that. It's how many pounds did they remove? And that's always been fun, because, I mean, I'm in Oregon. We weren't really talking about, oh, they donated $1. No, they removed 1 pound of plastic. So that's been really fun. And keeping that real and keeping it transparent has been really fun. So the next stage I'm really excited about is, we're not going to write this grant to go to Hawaii and remove 1 million pounds of plastic. We've already got it. We're going to go remove it. We're going to put it on our own property in containers. Then we're going to call the government and ask them what they want to do with their plastic, because it's not my plastic, it's theirs. So we're really excited about that, and they're going to be excited too, because what will they do with it? What jobs will be created? I don't know. I can't wait.
Okay. Can you tell me what brings you out to this? Why did you come?
We came for our science project, and it's about ocean pollution, and we wanted to like help clean up and see like how much pollution there really is on the beach.
Yeah, we're both in the same biology class, and it's part of an environmental service project that we do. And our topic for our proposal was plastic pollution, and we're focusing on bioplastics and bioaccumulation of plastics. And
What does that do to in the oceans?
It's not good. It builds up in the fish that eat it, the shellfish that absorb it, and then we consume it. And unfortunately, it comes from our clothes, it comes from things that we use to clean our body, you know, loofahs, things like that, that all sheds and reaches the ocean eventually.
So you think you can make a difference, just one person?
Not just me, but every little bit helps. Okay.